foot. We have a couple of clips to start off with. Calm, this one's going to go to you. This is a 1v2 clutch, I believe, from the second game. Can you kind of just share us what was going through your head, what you were thinking as this play was going down?
Away, he'll get this half before he even emerges around the corner. That's an easy kill onto the planter. Just one.
I will say during this clutch, I was like, oh my god, I'm Ethan. Because
that didn't feel like Ethan.
Ethan has insane jiggles, and I usually have like okay jiggles, you know. And then I was like, oh god, I'm insane. that's what was going through my mind. I was just like, I'm aiming like Ethan right now.
Also, we threw this round, so you should have been tilted at us. The round where we literally ran a dot.
What do y'all do?
You don't want
a dot.
You don't want me to look at this.
You don't want
to. You don't.
If I look at this Bible, I'd be pissed.
Yes, you'd be pissed.
Oh, you're wow.
Very pissed. Look at Max. What is he holding? All right,
Max.
All right, guys, we got one more. Now this is coming to Jawgemo. This was, I believe, your some ridiculous shots. Again, just kind of walk us through what's going on.
He makes it to the site. What the
Rosa?
Yeah, you guys.
I had a phantom.
No. When you killed this guy, I was like,
what? So I Rosa'd. Can you play it back real quick? It was too fast for me. I didn't even know what I did. But basically what I did was I was trying to shoot the guy through the, you know, the tube with the ult and try to do damage. Man, I didn't get no damage off because it was like a bad wall, I guess. But I mean, I was just flicking. I was just trying to make sure that my teammates can trade off me. I was just shooting everything I can in sight. That's basically it.
Running around.
Yeah, just running around, having fun, satcheling around.
What's going on on the comms channels while those plays are going down?
I was just laughing.
I was probably just saying, I'm coming, Jaw. And then so Jaw is just doing his best to live. And he did a good job.
And then
I get that kill.
And then after the round, I was like, I was doing one of those. Oh, wow.
Had a mechanics out.
Mechanics.
Awesome. And this is our final clip. I believe this one is coming from Ethan. This is him picking up a 4K. So just kind of walk us through what's going on.
The confidence coming from Boosters, he to try and push through
the
that
jiggles.
Smoke.
One half.
Like, we've already seen
two bulls going
to bring back a huge deficit.
Oh my god, Boosty.
He's a different.
Ethan, what do you think?
I mean, it was perfect.
Perfect player.
Literally perfection. They missed the best part. It was between the three kills and the last kill. Perfect movement. Yeah, that was the best part. Forget the kills.
He made sure to live the whole clip, and it skips that. It's fine.
That's messed up.
Right here.
All right. Awesome, guys. We're going to move on to some pre-submitted questions. Let us take a look. This one is coming to Boostio. It's from the Valorant competitive community. EG has played Pearl twice already, and though the defensive side has looked really strong, the attack side has been more of a struggle. Is this because of issues with strats and calling, or just mistakes in executing the game plan?
I think Pearl's one of my weaker maps to call on, to be honest, compared to other maps. But I think our strats are fine. I think the calling can be fine, just sometimes we just run our head into the wall. And we just need to adapt, and we'll be better.
Thank you. We'll now move to the remote media. Please use the Zoom hand raise function if you'd like to ask a question, and then we'll call on you. Let's start with Brandon from esports.gg.
Thank you very much. I'll ask this to Boostio as well, and I'll preface this for content's sake. I am trying to stir the pot here. After the BLG victory against NRG, someone asked Knight what he thought about your comments regarding Chinese Valorant not being able to potentially keep up with NA. And the translation was something to the effect of, if maybe Boaster had said it, it would matter because you were the runners up. Or if Boaster was the IGL of EG, maybe you wouldn't have been the runners up. So I just want to hear your response to those comments.
I don't even know who that kid is. So the comments don't really matter. I've never seen him play once. NRG, everyone knows NRG is bad at the start of a tournament. So it's not that much praise to beat them early. We'll see if they make it out of groups. Good luck.
Thank you. We'll go to Nerditude. Go ahead.
Thank you so much. My question is for Ethan. In the last Master at Tokyo, you won against Foot 2-0. Did you guys were confident about the last result, or did you expect a more complicated one?
They pretty much played the same other than comms. So
it felt pretty similar. I think we're also a lot better now than we were at the start of Tokyo. So maybe that's why.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Brandon, I see your hand is still back up. Did you have a follow-up question?
Yes, I'd also like to ask a question to Ethan. Throughout the year, we had spoken regarding, you know, the team's stamina and how that was kind of a major focus to make sure the team was prepared to be able to stick out these longer games, you know, with a couple best of fives now under you guys' belt, you know, a lot of overtime periods happening at this tournament. I just kind of like to ask you if there was any special preparation for that coming in to Champions when you had that time, you know, during everyone else in the LCQ.
Yeah, I mean, we're also just getting a lot of experience we played two VO5s in Tokyo, so that was a lot. We played two VO5s leading up to the qualification for Tokyo. And we're also practicing, you know, multiple scrims in a row to kind of get us prepared for that too. So I think all that helps. And, you know, we're just getting the experience. I think people are starting to get a hang of it now.
Thank you. We're going to go next to Jin from Quang Valorant in Vietnam.
So, hello, Evo Junior. Congratulations for reaching to the playoff. And I have a question for Demon One. I don't know, how do you feeling to reach to the playoff? And what team you want to meet in the playoff too? Thank you so much.
It was Fnatic.
You want to get a revenge in the final in Master Tokyo, right?
Yeah. That's like the only team I have to beat.
Okay. Do you think which player do you focus a mode on Fnatic?
Focus? I mean, I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. We'll go next to Zen from Strafe Esports.
Hey guys, congratulations on your win. I wanted to ask you guys on both those maps that you played. We saw on Pearl and then on Bind as well, you guys were off to really hot streaks where you were super dominant. And then Foot just ended up pulling it back to overtime on the first map and then pretty close on the second map as well. What were the main things that Foot were doing that sort of stopped working for you guys? And the main difficulties that you faced, especially calling and stem. I can direct this one to Boostio.
Yeah. I think, on defense, a lot of it was my fault. I kept dying short, and their Viper was doing a really good job of just, like, not giving us the info short. And just in the rounds previous, we were just owning them short, and I think that was a big part. And then for the attack, we just kind of read them and just, like, called plays, and they worked, and just read them. Pretty easy.
Thank you. Are there any questions from the room? Last call for any questions from the online media. Evil geniuses, congratulations on your victory. Thank you for taking the time to speak with us today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.